This is, at the end of the day, about a part of our mission. The Alzheimer's Association is the national movement to address Alzheimer's disease and related disorders. We believe, and Dr. Longo is going to give you some evidence of this, that we can see a future where our children and grandchildren neither have Alzheimer's nor care for someone who does. We absolutely believe we can beat this thing. We're proud to be the largest private non-funders of Alzheimer's science in the world. What did I say?
Non-funders.
Oh. Yeah. The largest private non-profit funders of Alzheimer's science. Yes. It'd be easy to be the largest non-funder. And at the same time, we offer a host of wonderful programs to help families through this journey for which oftentimes they were unprepared. We have a 24/7 helpline. We offer wonderful education programs. This is one example of that. We have caregiver support groups. We have early stage programs for people with a diagnosis. I mentioned our helpline 24/7. You can call us and talk to trained professionals. 15,000 calls our chapter. Our chapter serves from Fresno to the Oregon border in the upper third of Nevada. We have 10 offices in that territory. Last year, we took 15,000 calls in that territory. But no one calls the office in the morning saying, how's research going today? They call because something's happening in their lives and they need help, and that's what we're there for. And at the same time, as I said before, we absolutely believe we can beat this thing. You're going to hear more about that today. I wanted to share one piece of information before I introduce Dr. Longo. In January, the headline about the congressional budget reconciliation was that finally the Republicans and the Democrats agreed on a budget. What you probably didn't read about was that in that budget was the approval of the Alzheimer's Accountability Act. I've told you before, if you've been here, in 2011, we helped to write, we dreamt of, and we got past the National Alzheimer's Project Act. Out of that came, from the Department of Health and Human Services, the first ever U.S. national plan to address Alzheimer's disease. A year ago in the budget, we got an additional $100 million to the baseline of NIH funding for Alzheimer's disease. Now, yeah, well, that's good. But federal funding for Alzheimer's science is about $580 million. Federal funding for cancer is about $5 billion. I just say that to give you scale, not because we begrudge cancer a nickel. That investment in cancer science has been an excellent investment. Most of us know somebody who has survived cancer. None of us know anyone who has survived Alzheimer's disease yet. We'll get there. My point is the Alzheimer's Accountability Act. What did it mean? Sometimes I've been to Washington for our public policy forum year after year after year. You meet with Congress folk, and it's not uncommon for them to say, well, we don't want to pick the winners and losers. We want the scientists to decide. The Alzheimer's Accountability Act requires the NIH to sit with their scientists and submit directly to Congress in what's called a professional judgment budget or a bypass budget. Directly to Congress what the scientists think it will take to have disease-modifying treatments by 2025. By the way, the only other two conditions that have such a bypass budget are cancer and HIV/AIDS, the number one and the number two most well-funded issues in the National Institutes of Health. So we think this is going to make a difference. We will, of course, be there. It doesn't require Congress to fund it, but they will be able to say their scientists told them what it will take to achieve their plan. So we'll be there and we'll be after that, and you'll be part of it.